I'm cutting scallions for my bae.
It's really cute, Julien.
You like the scallions? Sweetie.
Yeah, bae. I was over there because Julien was cutting them up and he was like, oh, I made scallions for my bae. And I came over and I was like, is that a heart?
Oh. It's a heart.
Ow! My heart hurts from that being the cutest thing ever.
Scallion game on point. In the kitchen, I'm known as the obliterator. I just cut things up. The obliterator. Every kitchen needs one, but I'm the obliterator this kitchen needs, but it doesn't deserve. Wait, is that how it goes? I'm the obliterator that Gotham needs, but Batman's already there obliterating everything. I'm cutting while I vlog, it's so safe. I'm really good at cutting things out. I just take my focus and the knife and then the cutting board and then I'm done. Done. Obliterator. That is a work of art.
Julien, Bing, and walk my start.
BRB, gonna go for a quick walk.
Will you help me? No.
What are we making?
We're making pad thai.
Homemade pad thai.
Some vegan pad thai. Vegan and gluten-free because Julien's wheelchair.
Wheelchair.
Special. You're special.
I'm so special.
That's all that means. You're just special.
Yep.
PG, leave him alone. PG girl.
If you could smell that through the video, you'd be happy with your smell.
Is this mine or yours?
It's yours.
Oh, okay.
Have a little more off.
I'm a bunch of noodles. Yeah, hit me with them noodles.
Damn! For those cooking connoisseurs out there and the chefs who really know what they're doing, shut up. I should be walking while it's... I think you're supposed to keep it on the flame while you walk it. You know?
Oh, I see. Why don't you just stir it instead of shaking it? Yeah, there you go. Whisk it first. Whisk it. Quit whisking. You need like a really spicy pad thai sauce. OMFNG. Oh my god, it looks bomb.
We made fucking pad thai. That's crazy.
When I was in Singapore, they made noodles like this. It's like street food, you know what I mean? They just make
they
it
make
for
it
you
on, yeah.
In like 5 minutes. They just throw a bunch of stuff in there.
And those are always the best ones. The
yeah,
ones
it was incredible. Yeah. And I was like, you realize how long they would take you to make
these? Yeah, like when I was a kid, they used to make, like down by the Staples Center, on the corners, they would have these hot dogs wrapped in bacon with these onions. And they tasted so good. And one day, like on a Sunday, I took like the whole day to try to replicate it, and it was like half as good.
Yeah. Babe, I don't want to hold it.
Just
put
it on the plate.
Okay, thank you. It's not safe.
You're so scared of the obliterator. As you should be.
No, it's not safe.
Obliterator. We just finished our pad thai. How's that looking?
It looks so good. I want to put the nuts and the cilantro and lime on it.
Like, this looks pretty good. I mean, for our first try, it smells good, it tastes good. It all checks out. Yeah, I'm going to add some peanuts, even though my favorite part is just the noodles. Cilantro is banging, and then you squirt some lime, which is scary when your hands are full of cuts and broken calluses. Well, now we're gonna go indulge and then overindulge in our amazing homemade pad thai. I will link the
recipe.
I'll link the recipe that Jenna found on Pinterest, and so you guys can make this, and maybe you can let me know how you do. We're gonna go get fat.
Well, to be clear, if you do link it, the instructions of how to cook it is like really confusing.
Yeah, it's like there's it's more like, than like
take
20
the green,
steps.
Yeah, put the greens in, take the greens out, put the onions in, take the onions out.
Yeah.
If you like read it a couple times and simplify it for yourself, then it's good.
Yeah, and also don't get a non-stick wok. Those are bad. Get a stick wok. One without the non-stick coating because the non-stick stuff like affects how everything cooks. So don't get a non-stick wok. Make your own pad thai. See you later. Bye.